I'm very grateful for being part of this valuable conference. I'm also very impressed and envious of this new building of the institute. I tried to build a new building when I served the director of the Korean University, but I failed to mobilize enough funding. So I admire the Professor Imyeon-jin's capability and leadership to establish the wonderful center. I hope and expect SMU's Asia Center to play the leading role in the Asian style. Coming years. Well, my title of my presentation is How Can East Asian Academia Become a Center of Asian Studies? The theme touches upon many issues already mentioned by Professor Kang Myung-gu and other scholars. And I prepare a short essay. You can find my essay in the proceedings. So I briefly deliver my idea and reflection on the East Asian studies in East Asia. As we all know, despite growing political and economic influence of East Asia, still East Asia remains peripheral in the international knowledge order. Talented students from East Asia still prefer to study in the United States or Europe. And also, East Asian researchers generally remain in the position of importing theory and knowledge from the West. The situation of Asian studies is not different. The United States and European academia remain in the dominant position in Asian studies. And by contrast, the history of regional level study of East Asia is relatively short, and academia of individual East Asian country has not been competent in producing high-class knowledge and not very active in exchanging information with these Western companies. In addition, the situation of East Asian think tank responsible for studying key national policies seems no exception. According to reports published in 2014 this year by Global Go-To Think Tank, while 14 American institutes and 7 European institutes made the top 25, only 2 East Asian think tanks, 1 Japanese and 1 Chinese, made the list. There's no Korean institute in the list. Why? Why does East Asian academia remain peripheral in the studies on their own vision? I suggest 3 reasons. First, overall weakness of knowledge ecosystem, including university and research institute in this region. To be short, the history of academia and financial base is so relatively weak. And second reason has to do with the lack of academic exchange and weak academic network among researchers and research institutes in this region. As many people already mentioned, East Asian countries seem to be very limited discipline-specific academic exchange. And East Asia does not have a significant society for Asian studies, such as the AAS. Certainly, difficulty in communication by language barrier also has been the obstacle. I skipped this part. You already know. What should be done to change this situation? The first and most important task is to improve our research ability and to produce high quality knowledge to attract the attention of Western counterparts. To do so, I suggest 5 strategies. First, the more research attention needs to be paid to research that regards East Asia as a unit of analysis. In other words, we need to go beyond single country studies, and we need to transcend national boundary of East Asian studies. And secondly, more focus should be given to inter-country or inter-stakeholder relationship in the East Asian. Korea-Japan diplomatic relations, Korea-China conflicts, or territorial dispute between China and Japan would be good example. And thirdly, more attention needs to be placed on interstate comparative study in East Asian region. Yeah, comparison of major social phenomena and policy among Korea, China, Japan, and other Southeast Asia will reveal the similarity and differences among them. Firstly, interdisciplinary study that transcends the boundary of humanity and social science need to actively take place so that holistic interdisciplinary research is undertaken. Level of study on East Asia will greatly improve. Last but not the least, efforts need to be made to spread and communicate throughout the world the high quality research output of East Asia. For this purpose, publishing papers in other languages, including English, and the disseminating our research output is critical. And also the translating the existing high quality research output into other languages is also very important. Another way for drawing world attention to East Asian studies produced within East Asia itself to present this unique perspective, different from the that of West. Western academia has led research on East Asia. But at the same time, Western frame and methodology has become very influential. It doesn't mean we should exclude Western methodology or epistemology or value, but there's no question. Western frame and perspective, influence our study. So it's time to critically evaluate Western bias and perspective. Finally, East Asian region, institutional and academic exchange and research among ourselves. Recently, academic exchange among the three nations are more active than before. Major academic societies are conducting more cross-country seminars in this region, and research institutions more aggressively engaged in joint research activities. The Campus Asia program, which is a student exchange and joint research scheme among the three nations, hopefully will serve as a historic opportunity for the academic exchange among the countries. When I served director of ARI, I established East Asia Community Forum, so-called. The one of the major institutes, the Tokyo University and Tsinghua University in China and Korea University, organized this forum by every year. So inviting other scholars from the West, and so we try to initiate our perspective and research team. I think it's a good example. I hope the Asia Center of SMU will play a similar role. And we all know European intellectuals, such as John Money, play a pioneering role in the establishment of the European Union a long time ago. Likewise, now it's time. East Asian scholars, academics, have a strong obligation to develop competency to generate high quality knowledge on our own region. Furthermore, East Asian academics should play a leading role in overcoming bitter memory of colonial rule and current confrontation of territorial history. So we can continue foster peace and co-prosperity in this region. Thank you for listening. I stop here.